Heinrich Emerson, and welcome back to Outlook Portland on Portland CW. Today, as we get ready to wrap up this holiday program, we've been talking to Scrooge and Santa about greed and giving. And we've resolved perhaps some things, but left a great many things unaddressed, unanswered. Santa, something that we touched on earlier that I want to give you a full chance to respond to. Ebenezer Scrooge had mentioned how your physical appearance, certainly today, differs from what we might call the classic Santa, depicted in literature, depicted in films. Do you feel that maintaining this image, perhaps past the point of realism, is detrimental? Do you feel that there is perhaps a hint of insincerity, of marketing, in preserving this this image?
It's a good question, Rick. It can be said that my job is a daunting one. There are billions, if not trillions, of children on this earth who need to be reminded of the spirit of giving, the spirit of the holidays. And for one man to have such a daunting task resting upon his shoulders would be not practical.
Well, what about the multiple Santas you see on every street corner? Well, yesterday I walked past four separate Santas of four separate ethnic backgrounds within the span of one city block.
This is actually something that I wanted to get into, and I'm glad that this has been brought up. This is a question that many people, especially many children, have. The logistics of not only gift delivery, but of, as you said, multiple Santas throughout town. Do you feel that this is harmful to children and their perception of Santa, of giving, of the holiday season? How do you explain this?
Not at all, Rick. To explain how I cover so much terrain on that holiest and magical of nights every December, 4 years ago, I traded in my gasoline-powered sleigh for a sleigh that runs on enchantment and recycled tinsel, because I care about the environment and I wish for the ozone layer to remain fortified to keep me warm on my longest of journeys.
And Scrooge, that would seem to indicate that Santa is not merely mouthing these words about giving and about wanting to preserve happiness for all. He is not only giving, he is not only distributing joy and happiness to children and to people of all ages around the world, he is in fact environmentally conscious. It seems that this is a very sincere outlook on life that Santa has, just as your outlook is sincere. Can we at least agree here at this table in this holiday season that each of you does come from a place of true belief regarding these ideas, however your differences might clash with those of your opponent?
Well, both greed and giving are both ideas, and ideas exist in imagination, and that's obviously where the two of us are based out of.
One must ask this question. Scrooge, what have you always wanted for Christmas but never received? What is the first gift that Scrooge remembers asking for and not getting?
Well, I wasn't prepared for anything like this. When I was a young boy, I remember distinctly asking my great aunt for an abacus, which was filled with beautiful ivory beads. And I remember distinctly, that's really where my love of counting came from, which led to my love of commerce and how the whole supply and demand universe works. And that abacus never came. I had to work, I had to build up my own portfolio and then purchase it myself.
So I think we can see that perhaps some of Scrooge's disenchantment with his holiday season does come from the feeling that sometimes one does not receive exactly what one wished for. Santa, can things like this be rectified? Can things like this be fixed and made whole in the future?
I believe they can, Rick. And to answer your question about what gift I've always wanted and never received, it was a beard trimmer.
Well, I think that the two of you might have some shopping to do this holiday season.
I doubt it, Rick, but one can dream.
I do all mine online.
I'd like to thank you both for being
typical.
Here. Santa and Ebenezer Scrooge. Hey, don't forget, after February 17th, analog transmission of this very fine television program and network ceases and we go all digital. Don't be left in the dark. Go to portlandcw.com to find out more. And I would like to thank all of you for watching, and I'd like to wish all of you, from all of us and everyone at the CW, everyone in Portland, from everyone here, the merriest of Christmases and the happiest of holidays. I'll see you next time. I'm Rick Emerson. Insert trademark catchphrase here. This is Outlook Portland on Portland's CW.